that's where he's currently based. Some of you might know his work from last year's Singapore Biennale. He was also in the Asian Art Biennial in Taipei last year, and later this year will be in the Moscow Biennale. This body of work is called Human Nature, and all of these photographs are from taken inside the homes of people who live in a community called the White Building in Phnom Penh. The White Building was built in 1963 as social housing for artists. And as you can see, it's quite a unique environment today. So I thought, Sanang, if you'd like to start by telling us a bit about the White Building, why you chose the White Building.
Before we can talk about why we interesting building to take people there, because during that the 2009 we ran the space that called Source of Art Space Project. We added non-profit, for teaching painting class and also photo class and some exchange workshop sharing each other in that space. So it's kind of we are family, kind of family, because we live together and always connecting with the people in there. And people in there kind of collaboration, because they are the artists. Some artists still in there, because in 1999, during the Khmer Rouge, 1995 and to 1979, had the Khmer Rouge. So 90% artists working. So after Khmer Rouge, the Ministry of Culture asked less artists come to live together along the building. So easy to connecting each other, develop again, don't have mobile phone during the time they put in the phone. So yeah, and then so I back to for me that why we come to the Bible building, to choose the Bible building to make a space and work this project. Of course this building has a very wonderful building for so nice and choose like have environment like lighting, air, something good and also why I make this project with people in there, because of when during the work I have the space in there, we always know each other and people always ask me about, you know, when they buy this building, how much I will get the money, because they already know a situation in like strategy, investment and government destroy the building or move people out from the area development plan. So around this area in the white building already gone and keep silent space and look like waiting this building. So like the old building, like the theater or something. Yeah.
It was at the time when you took these photographs. Mm-hmm. That was at the time when a slum community next to the white building, with around 4,000 residents, were forcibly evicted. So at the time you were taking these photographs, people had seen that happen, and that was very much fresh on their minds.
So being them like very stressful, because already people that they have been moved very cheap price, they live very far from the city, and no electricity, no clean water, no school, like kind of a community. So like new life, like some land, no tree, only land like in a field, right? So people thinking what they can survive. So, and then we start to talk with them about what do you think if you love the white building. The people talk very different, something. They will love this local area. They said easy to work, easy to go to school, easy to go to market, easy to go to a pagoda. Everything easy. If they say if they will sell this, how much they can get? They can buy a new one and can buy the new house in this area or not? So yeah, and then give me some interview and some why I give them wear the mask. Kind of some people very scary about political, and I just recording the voice, they say no something, and someone family they have husband so angry with me that I took a picture something. They said, you know political, you don't know political, very effort to everyone, you don't know a neighborhood they love who are the party, opposite party or the party now or something. And then I said, okay, I have the idea. You worry about it, I have something. Give you more fact, you fact, something show your real that you want, like something like not only like give them cover them the face, but like the mask that I make and give them, like they choose the mask that they made, that I can say, I give many masks to each person to choose each one. Like how they choose, and after that I feel like they choose the mask, this kind of the new mask, the new face or something that's strong, power and can say something that they can say.
Yeah. So maybe now's a good time for you to introduce us to some of these people. Mm-hmm. Maybe do you want to start with the woman over here?
Yeah, this woman, when they unlock the door or something, that I know her daughter, she is a dancer. So her family, this the dancer and the painter. So when I come, I'm very easy. Come to take them and say, like, introduce myself, where I'm from, like, I'm from the Bai building, so they know. They know so-so. Every kid, they know so-so. And always the kid, they call me, I'm teacher. and then she sleep like this, but just in a little in the front. So when I come, and then I set up tripod, she asked me, where should we shoot? No, you already have the good plan already. I found this place already, don't move. And then when I shoot, and the dog come in. So, yeah.
So that was quite important for you, not to, that you weren't changing what was in the house, you were just showing what was there.
Yeah,
at,
like
at that time, at that time around 2010, mm-hmm. a lot of artists in Cambodia, especially in the art collective that you're part of, mm-hmm. Thought a lot about documentary, wanting mm-hmm. to document mm-hmm. the reality of Cambodia today.
Yeah.
Can you talk a little bit about why that was important for you?
Yeah, during the when we learned photo class in 2006 and 2007, so after that we made a steel sulapa, they call Arriba. Yeah, and also have the gallery run by Cambodian artists. So the first time in Cambodia. So and then say like always we talking, sharing each other. Because we are poor about technique or contemporary art in Cambodia. Then, yeah, of course, we are sharing something and we are discussing different perspectives. But one thing that Roger asked me, we are thinking about, yeah, during, you know, when we need to find a documentary on our country, how will we ask for them, friend? Around the world, something, but especially French people have a lot. They keep this very important for Cambodian using the history. And by now, we are photographers. Why we don't take something around our community or where we happen? We should be keep it very important in the future when we change something. So yeah, we start different thing. Street photo or maybe something, take something, something or find a house. I have a meeting with my friend and her husband or like a newspaper, the journalist, they can call me like, okay, sometimes 5 o'clock I can run to take picture. Just keep like, I don't know what did do this photo, but I think that the important keep it in the future. Yeah, and then some like this kind for me is kind of a documentary also. Like you see now it changed. Like this now become to our space, like social asset project.
So now when you took this picture, this was her that girl's house, mm-hmm. and then after that she left, and then
we rent the space. So now it become the viable clean, become to artist, come to live in the space. And then I come like see like some culture, like they love to paint all photos. Different rich people now, they are like in the some Europe or something, they hang the artwork. Some Europe or something, they hang, they love their portrait, their family, like sometimes long ago, like you know, they see, oh, they his, her son have been something, the history in their own home. So,
it was a bit of a funny story about this picture, wasn't it?
Mm. Yeah, also I asked his parent to take a picture. And I take, and then I said, oh, you want to take or not? The kid want to take a picture inside the frame or not? And like he still in her picture and said, come on. And then he lazy. Already don't have the eye, have the hole in the mouth. Already open like this, so no, I'm not definitely, and then he do that. And then I shoot this one, yeah. I shoot this one.
Did they choose the mask they
wanted
to wear, or did you make the mask, or did they make
the mask? Yeah. I made the mask, and then different mask. So I bring different masks. I want to give them choose which one they like. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And your men all have
their
shirt on.
Yeah, you know, it's in Cambodian. Like I know, like I start to have underwear when I have a time when I know when I try because I feel like, oh my god, I'm not like a kid now, I change. So Cambodian like no shirt, and Japanese found, say okay, then they try, they want to wear the shirt, that no, I'm a kind of documentary, this your normal life, right? Okay, so we do this.
So for those of you who haven't seen yet, you can have a look later, but in the small room over here on this side, it's a photograph of a young boy wearing a tiger's mask. Mm-hmm. And that boy was one of the first students who studied in the free art classes that Samnang and his friends...
Not tiger mask, it's like peacock.
Peacock mask.
Yeah.
Why do you call him a tiger then?
A tiger in there.
Do you want to talk about that boy in the peacock mask then? The one of the first people to study in the art classes that you teach is also mm-hmm. art projects. And that was now 4 years ago. You're still teaching those art classes. Mm-hmm. Maybe you can tell us a bit about that, about the workshops and classes you teach.
Yeah. So, like 2 or 3 years already that the social asset project, step by step, everyone knows social, especially like you come. Like you are like foreigner, when you come, my student or kid they know come to SOSO. Yeah, it's very a little hard to find because many apartments, so and many room, and then say come with me, and they will bring you to SOSO. So everyone knows step by step, and so we have different workshop, always recently at different countries come to our space. To do the same, so or actually we have something major project about talking about IBD, to view the people, paint, drawing something that they want. They want to say. So they hit this kind of like my student or come to join our way. I teach the painting class and he looking the my class. And when we have the another project for the kid, they can come paint together. And always when we have anything that the family helpful, sharing.
So one of the themes in a lot of the workshops and classes you have is allowing people to kind of share in the share with the rest of Phnom Penh, that sense of community. Share with outside in Phnom Penh, the sense of community they have inside the work building.
Yeah. Of course, they always never get and forget about the concept about the community to paint or something in the they painting in the paper or something in the form. So yeah, of course they say something very interesting. Some they said, I saw this here like the community here help each other. You know, kind of a strength that them like different another community they don't have art class something come, they don't know how to say something connecting. I think like this art can combine the people sharing each other. Like actually, like we have one Japanese artist. His name Masaru Aiwei. He come to the our space 3 months. His project kind of clean, so he show the stair of the white building. He want to clean there, and one neighborhood, like room like this, you know. So he buy the color white color, paint the neighborhood, and clean the stair. But step by step, you know, we don't ask them to this book. We do it like the social team help them. And step by step, people bring the water, bring something, they clean, have to clean together. Like help hand, like, oh my god, what's that? You know, and come together like we more than we are planned. I think that, okay, this art, and come, bring people connecting.
So one of the important things about these pictures is that you show the reality of these people's lives, but not with pity. You don't pity them, mm-hmm. You show you have a sense of respect mm-hmm. for them, and you show the dignity of the people.
Mm-hmm.
Can you talk to us about how you, about that feeling, and even when the people wear the mask, how do they show their personality?
Yeah, for me, like, I mean, like, I don't pity them, but I think like they have something can like the saying like kind of find the flat of the way they saying like I wear the mask something like not look like pity, but some they face the mask. Kind of the new thing of them, like although like strong face of them, a strong heart, a strong feeling, a strong voice, a strong thinking, a strong future thing. Out from the new mask, like the new face for them.
In the series you made after this called Untitled, which is the one that was in the Singapore Biennale, where some man tipped a bucket of sand over his head. There's a few of those photographs in this small room here, if you'd like to take a look. I think it's the same feeling in those pictures. That work was about a lake called Bangkok in central Phnom Penh, where 4,000 families, or about 17,000 people, were forced out of their homes because the lake was filled with sand. And I think, Samang, when you tip the bucket of sand over your head, you show us that you feel pity for those people,
mm-hmm.
but also that you feel respect for them, for
mm-hmm.
Their bravery.
Mm-hmm.
How brave they were.
Mm-hmm.
Can you talk to us a bit more about the connection, if there's any connection for you between this series, Human Nature, and the next series, Untitled?
So, I can interview about why the problem in that area they call Bangkok Lek, that 4,000 families was moved, and now they have big problem before come to no house, no place to live, no like no job also. So the Phnom Penh city is about so lower 12 meters from the sea level. So mean the city should be keep the lake for helpful during rainy season.
It prevents the floods.
Yeah, the flooding. So, why they make different roads, like we see Rusi Road and 271 roads, like kind of the block, the development, the main road, like the bend of the block, water become like a land also. Okay, so now they fear all about this. And yeah. And I back to project question about not the pity or but I respect them because yeah of course to think that I don't know I did I okay I have my fellow if I want to know I need to go there if I want to make art which something happened I when I hear the news I read the news I hear the radio. Not enough for me. I said maybe I come and I have some smell. I can touch. I can see real. So I come many times. Many times, come back many times with that area that I drop the sand. And also talk with them. I'm not take a picture with them, but I talk with them. What do you think? Okay. you agree with selling this price, you can buy the new house. They said, yeah, what can I do? Who are happy? Even army come to this, pressure to them, but who are happy? Because government already pressure to them, who are happy? NGO, okay, NGO say, but not affect to government. And yeah, of course, they said, what do you see? You see the sand coming to step by step every day to the lake. One area they start, so sand, planting, you see the house, planting in the nearly all the roof. So, yeah, and then one time that I saw the strategy, example around the area one block. They buy the house. They buy the house, buy house, buy house, like two house, don't want to sell. They move sand them. And they say, your house under sand. It's my land. You know? And then during that people try to escape, bring the stuff out, you know. This is the last they he need to move. If they don't move, they will die. So I saw something like that and give me reflect something to say for myself, like my experience or my thing to do, drop the sand to my body, and maybe I want to test about sand, what happened in really affect me, something if I in the water and sand coming, what feeling did to me, something like this question to me. And I try to answer to like experiment answer.
Mm. Anyone else have any more questions on that?
Another question. I know that you have personal relationships with all these people, and that's sort of forms the foundation for this series of work. But when you put the mask on, as Roger said, you eliminate. Well, you photograph them without pity, but also. Without sympathy and to some extent without empathy when they wear this mask. And this way of documenting individuals, frame, camera, sort of renders document people?
Mm-hmm. I think all together combined. I think they, I believe myself, I believe my thing that I know, that I live in there also. I sit in there also. I know history also. I have situation, political also. And we come together. And then by reflect to me to do that, the ultimately, maybe I know everything in do around me. Yeah, maybe one before I did this, I have been one project about self-portrait, 800 students in my class at Takai province, 80 kilometers from the city. So I teach art in the high school. That the strange one, never had a teacher in the high school that at the Kai province. So yeah, of course, like I said before, maybe everything connecting, everything that I know, I learned. Yeah.
I have to things differ. I think the photo show a lot of empathy, even though they have the mask. I think for me the mask says like this is that person, but it could be many. And these homes, they show the histories of these people, and like all these incense in there, up there, and all the times they burned those incense and what they were doing, and the dishes and the laundry. And so there's all these histories in these spaces, and it could be, could be anybody. These things could happen to anybody, and many people live like that. That's the way I take it. I didn't take it as I just went with it. That's not having empathy because of the use of the mask.
And then people got people done that. I think about that future. They face this day face.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Not mask, but this face. But my mask. Mm-hmm. This face.
It's their history. Yeah.
Is there a feeling anywhere that your work is political at all? Not just this series, but Untitled or Newspaper Man? Mm-hmm.
How do you feel about that? Or body naked or something, it doesn't matter for me. But the important, how can I show? So I forget everything that this should be wrong word. Is very critical to the government or something. But if you say critical, it's critical. But see, this is for me, for my heart, my thinking. It's my thinking. Doesn't matter. Like also the last project, exhibition in Phnom Penh, the room not naked. They don't allow naked. But I said, like, it's my body. I take shower, you name and see your body in the shower room.
Subjects, but ultimately you're able to diffuse. use them in such a way, like using props or about inserting yourself in some kind of comical way? Is play a big part of it for you? Enjoying the process, being silly, acting, being childish? I mean, of course, not in a pejorative at all, but is this a part of your process?
It's important or not important that I always my work is fun. That sometimes you see this fun, but sometimes after you step more things, not fun. Like you see the Sumnang Khao taxi, Musen that I like send in the city to have the band of river, because they spend a lot of sand, like I tell you before, they spend a lot of sand from the river to the lake. Many lakes, not only one lake, but many lakes in the around the city. So the band of river lost sand. So I collecting the sand one day in the city from the street to walk 3 days to the bend of river. So look like everyone fun to me. But after that, so they said, why you don't bring the car to ship your sand to the lake? And why you carry so hard like that to just spend one of the small box sand, like maybe 1 pound, to bring to the river? I said, yeah, of course, after they saw me fun, they see me, I'm not fun. I'm not fun. Yeah, of course, so it can be fun, but maybe not fun.
Thank you.
What has been the reaction of the government to your work?
What do you think?
What does the government think of your work? Has it been censored?
I think maybe I don't like government, maybe government don't like me also.
But have you been persecuted? Have you been...
Yeah. In here, nearly go to jail 2 times already. In Cambodia, and one in Tokyo, Tabata, nearly also. See, no.
So they haven't been censored. He hasn't had exhibitions closed down. But during the process of him making his work and taking his pictures, he's been arrested. Maybe you can talk to him more about that afterwards. Yeah. If there's no more questions, maybe just to finish, Sumnang, you can tell us what do you think, how do you feel about the future for contemporary art in Cambodia? Maybe you can tell us about some of your students who you've taught in your white building. What kind of work are they making? What can we expect to see next from young artists in Cambodia?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, of course. That's why I thank you for my teacher or our workshop in Cambodia that I've been learned, or in Japan also, in the first country that I've been far away and no speak English, no internet. I don't know how to play Facebook. And of course, so now we are starting have the social aspect project and still syllabus team come to not only help, you know, kind of to show something different thing, many choice for them to use they want. If they can want, they can choose anything then. So I bring brought different our spec, they call social asset project. The first in Cambodia, they have a business aspect also. And for bring an international or local famous artist or teacher something, or my friend just close from the city one day, have 1 hour, have art talk to present to the people community, the student in Cambodia. So, not only we have the class teaching, photo class, and also video. Even we don't know how video, but I have my friend come.
So you found all these different ways to show
and
to teach, but what is the work that now that the young students are making, people like Randall?
Now I got some students, two students become, maybe later I am free. They are following me. They did something more good idea than me. And now they come to helpful with our team and strong work. And have been show with me also. His work and my work come together. I mean, like, okay, I need to run. I stay with him. So yeah, okay. Now step by step, very effective to contemporary art. The art in Cambodia also kind of now the art different. Like they use different media also. Because I'm not graduate modern painting. But after I graduated, never paint. Photo, now crazy. Next year also. Of course, like I said before, I give them to different testing, different media. Give them which one you like, or you like all. Okay. And do sculpture, the last project that I did. I made sculpture that I don't know how I made sculpture, but I'm smart. I buy clay, and then I make clay very easy to cut something, like just like I can do, and then I scale it to the wood, and then I cut the wood, make something like look like similar or something different. Different play. So yeah, I ask myself about how beautiful sculpture that you like my life, I like, and how enough for my I want. Yeah, of course I need to ask my feeling. I don't stick to do, okay, I follow realist sculpture one or maybe Rodin or something, another sculpture from Europe is very like a human or something. But I say like, I'm not like him, it's me. Need to think like, how can I do? He asked me, I asked myself, ask me. And also, yeah, I can do like this. And also, I talk with the sculpture. Then sometimes sculpture that's like I make clay, beautiful or like okay, martial or something. But in the book, I cut, I feel something. Yeah, they say like yeah, but stop, it's good. Huh? Like I think my it's already open your eyes, look at me, cute or not? That's that, you. And that's the.
So now maybe we can stop.
So you don't have the same dialogue with your photographs. You have a different sort of dialogue with your photographic subjects,
so maybe
you can do sculpture.
Do your photographs talk to you?
Not talk to me, but
make me
scared.
Okay. Thank you everybody for coming. Thank you, Jody, Tintaba, and Tomio for having us. And if any of you would like to talk to Sunang afterwards, you can see he likes